Hey guys, what's up? Today we're going to talk about lookup tables and how to use it in your image. Before we jump into the scene, let's take a look at what are lookup tables and how to create a log profile to apply your LUTs. So to put it simple, logarithmic footage, generally known as log, is flat footage that contains more details of the scene it's baking into the image. This kind of footage is not intended to be used without editing, so it needs further alteration to be used as the final footage. In log footage, the purpose is to capture highlights, shadows, and whites with the highest range of precision by getting the most out of the camera's dynamic range. But what's missing in this recording mode are the colors. So it's necessary to color grade the log footage in post to get the colors back into the image. Videographers use log in order to get the best out of the shadows and all other details because they know they can generate the colors but not those details. So here I have an example showing my screen. Actually, I found this channel on YouTube. It's called Boxed, and this guy put some very interesting videos showing the log profile. So as you can see here, we have, this is the log profile, and then the color correction, the color correction is coming after it. So as you can see, all the color details, shadows, and everything is more enhanced. So it's very cool, right? So let's go to the Blender and see how to create this log profile and then generate a lookup table on Photoshop. Okay, so let's go. So guys, this is the scene we are going to work with. And as you can see, the scene is actually, it's pretty interesting, but what is not interesting at all is the color grade. So that's what we are going to work with. Okay, so first of all, we are going to kill all the settings and create this log profile. And then we are going to Photoshop and we are going to create our own lookup tables. Okay, so let's go. First thing we're going to do is we are going to change response type to sRGB. Also, the gamma, we are going to increase a little bit to bring more white to the scene. The vignette, I'm going to kill it as well. Also, the highlight compression, as you can see here on the edge of the armchair, we have some burn highlights like happening over here. So what we are going to do is increase to 1, and as you can see, now we have more information of the armchair. So that's what we need when you move to Photoshop and try to bring some colors to this image. We need a lot of information. We need a lot of color information, and this will help us a lot on in this case. Okay, so for this scene, I think that's it. Maybe we can increase a little bit more, maybe gamma 1.3, something like that. Okay, so that's enough. Okay, so let's go to Photoshop and see how to create lookup tables. Okay, here we are. So the first thing we're going to do is create a little bit of contrast to this scene. So I will create a curve. Maybe I'll push this up a little bit. Something like this. Yeah, remove a little bit of the shadows, and then I will switch to soft light. But you can always adjust it as you want, of course, but this is my start point. Cool. The next thing we're going to add is color balance. I will just a little bit to bring some warmth to this image. Something like this. Yeah, maybe 6. Yeah, I think 6 is a good number. So the next thing we're going to add is let me see. Too many. Okay, yeah, gradient map. So click reverse and then click to in the gradient. Here. Then here I'm going to change the colors a little bit and bring some nice warm and some cooler feeling to this scene. Something like this. Yeah, maybe bring more warm to the right, and I will apply a soft light as well. Yeah, very nice. So let's add another one. Maybe full saturation. Maybe it's too saturated. It saturate a little bit. This is something that I always do. As you can see, we already have a really nice result. Maybe we can add another curve. You play a little bit with these colors here. So the blue one maybe a little bit down. Remove a little bit of this blue cast shadows, and the red increase, decrease a little bit. Yeah. The RGB, that brings some contrast to it. Something like that. Yeah, not bad. And maybe another curve to bring some light to the scene. Looks pretty nice. Maybe adjust the curve, my start point. And yeah, looks pretty good. Okay, so how to export this lookup table? First I have to go to file, then go to export, then go to color lookup tables. And here you can add a name and export color lookup tables, and you have to activate cube. Okay, this is the main one. So then you can save and put any name you want. Okay, so let's see how it works in Blender. Okay, so let's import this LUT, this cube here, and increase the strength, and voila, we have our lookup table working on Blender, and looks pretty similar, actually looks identical. So that's the way I do my lookup tables, and of course I don't use the same technique all the time, but I have my start points, and this is my guide to my final image. Okay, so I hope you have enjoyed it, and see you in the next video.